Hey everybody, it's Alan, and I hope that you are doing well. So it is May the 9th, and that is Cheap Trick bass player Tom Peterson's birthday. Now, a viewer, Dave Blackwell, made a couple of suggestions about some Cheap Trick songs back when we had done a video celebrating Robin Zander. And I'm going to take the opportunity to play one of his requests right now. He suggested we do the song Daddy Should Have Stayed in High School.
Thank you.
So Cheap Trick, and Tom Petersson specifically, is one of those artists who truly benefit from the use of a somewhat obscure instrument in the sense that he primarily plays a 12-string bass. Now, a 12-string bass isn't exactly like a 12-string guitar. It's actually got 3 strings per note as opposed to 2 strings per note. So it's 4 sets of 3 strings tuned, obviously, in octaves. And what it does for a group like Cheap Trick is it really thickens up the tone. They put a little bit of distortion or a little bit of overdrive on the bass guitar, and it sort of acts like another rhythm guitar laying behind the foundation of what the band is. In other words, you know, guitar, bass, and drums. And so it thickens everything up. And at the shop, I recently got in a 12-string bass, and it was a Schecter Doug Pinnock model. Doug Pinnock, of course, of one of my favorite groups, King's X. And I sat down and I played it for a little bit, and it just has an incredibly, incredibly unique tone to it. And it makes you understand why, you know, groups like King's X and Cheap Trick and even Jimi Hendrix back in the 60s used a 12-string bass to sort of fill in some tones that you just couldn't get with a standard 4-string bass. And it's not the kind of tones that you can get by going to a 5-string bass or a 6-string bass. It can only be done with the octave tones that you get from a 12-string bass. And I know for a fact that Alan Woody from the Allman Brothers actually used a 12-string bass, actually used an 18-string bass quite a bit during his time with the Allman Brothers. And again, there's another instance where filling in the rhythm parts behind, you know, great guitar players and great musicians, just really thickening up the tone. It's sort of the reason why some bands choose to play with 2 drummers or a drummer and a percussionist, is to get those extra sounds that you can't get when just one musician is playing those parts. And I've always found Tom Petersson's sound really intriguing because of that 12-string bass. So happy birthday to Tom Petersson. Hope you all enjoyed this. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below, like Dave did. Thank you for the suggestion. I hadn't given this song much of a listen in the last, like, 2 decades, so thank you for the refresher, and the suggestion was perfect for celebrating Tom Petersson's birthday. So like I said, feel free to leave a comment. We can talk about it further. Just know that I appreciate all of you, and I wish you well. Take care.